Will Benedict, Will asks, I think I may vote for him. Maybe after listening to you now.
Hopefully.
Is he still an American citizen?
Yes, I am.
So you're a dual citizen?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. To make it very, very clear, in the eyes of the United States, I am an American citizen. In the eyes of the Filipino, Philippine Constitution, I am a Filipino citizen. Because the idea or the concept of American citizenship was conferred upon me not by choice, but by birth.
By birth, yeah.
I said there's an application of two laws here. One is called jus soli, which is by soil. That is the American version.
Okay.
If you are born anywhere in the United States, you can be from Iceland on vacation. Your mother gave birth to you there.
Uh-oh.
You're an automatic American citizen. And my parents happened to be studying at the University of San Francisco. My mother gave birth to me there. So that's the application of American law. Mm. So Philippines po, it's jus sanguine, by blood. And both my parents were Filipino citizens who never at any time opted for American citizenship. So sa mata po, in the eyes of the Philippine government, I'm a Filipino citizen. Mm. And that...
Galing mo magpaliwanag, tama yan.
Yeah, it went all the way to the Supreme Court. And the decision was actually penned by Supreme Court Justice Vicente Mendoza.
Now, you feel no pressure, although RA 9225 in 2003 actually pushed for the dual citizenship law, you feel no pressure to give up your American citizenship in any way for political reasons? Do you feel voters understand what you've just explained?
Everybody would like to go to America at what point in time in their lives. But they going to America, you would need a visa. You know, as a matter of fact, when I ran for vice mayor,
I'm listening.
It came to the point where I tore my passport as a sign of my loyalty to the Constitution of the Republic of the Philippines.
Wait, so pakikwento to, so you tore
my passport in public?
The American passport.
Yes, American passport, sorry.
So you tore your American passport
as a show.
What year was this?
This was 1998, right before the elections. It just so happened that my opponent opted to question my citizenship.
Yes, so, but are you still an American citizen today, even if you tore your American passport?
Make it very, very clear. I spoke to friends in the U.S. Embassy. A passport is not evidence of citizenship. It is a travel document. Mm. Okay?
Yeah.
So even if I say I'll throw away my U.S. passport, they will never give me a visa. Never.
So you don't have a visa now?
No, they will never give me a visa on my Philippine passport.
I see.
And their reasoning is, why will we give you a visa when we already recognize you as a U.S. citizen? If you come to America,
So what passport do you use now?
You carry both.
So after you tore your American passport in 1998, you got another American passport.
They issued me a new one.
Oh, they issued you?
Yes.
But did you have to apply for it?
Yes, because there were many times that I was supposed to go to the U.S. to attend conferences for the Optical Media Board.
So what you're saying is, when you tore your American passport, you cannot go to the U.S. naman using your Philippine passport because they refuse to issue you a visa because you are an American citizen. In their eyes, by birth.
By birth. Conferred upon by birth, not by choice.
So what do you make of Senator Grace Poe's situation wherein at one point what is being questioned to her was she renounced her Filipino citizenship.
Which she then reacquired.
Okay, explain.
And that's a matter of record. No, I don't want to be a legal eagle here.
Yeah, go. But how do you, then you tearing your American passport, you are running with Grace Poe, wherein also citizenship is the biggest challenge that she faces now.
Right. Based on what I've been hearing, I don't think the citizenship issue is being actually questioned anymore. Now it's supposedly based on her residence.
Okay.
But based on the facts that I have seen and read, I feel that she falls within the 10-year period that is required before an election.
Okay. Moms Rising Manila is asking, I was hoping, Karen, that Edu Manzano will run in Makati against Abinay.
I was asked.
Oh, for this?
For this election.
For what? Against for mayor or Congress?
I'd rather not say.
Sige na, no. I'm curious.
Yeah, I'm sure you are.
No, really? For what?
No.
Mayor, pero si Kid Peña will run eh.
No, no, I didn't say that.
Okay.
You said that.
Okay.
I was
so
asked
for what?
To join a party who was seeking truthful reform in Makati.
Oh.
But I had already registered in San Juan.
Yeah, but like what position would that have been?
I think it would be unfair to the candidate who accepted the position.
I won't ask the district.
No, not necessary.
Ooh.
Because if you're saying district, you're fishing for a congressional candidate.
Ah, so was it vice mayor?
See, again, you're fishing.
So
you're
why did you decline?
Basically,
other than you're registered in Makati, clearly it's something more.
Maybe if I was registered in Makati and I had spent a lot of time in Makati, but I think it would be also unfair to the residents if just because of an opening, I would come in again and try to reestablish roots.
Okay, so here is Edu Manzano. You are offering yourself to the Filipino people to vote for you in the Senate. Last words, and I think this is the start of a major campaign for you. I mean, people have to get to know you all over again.
We've been going all over the country.
Okay.
We've been speaking before schools and the universities. Mm-hmm.
So last words to our viewers.
You know, it's... We should ask and demand each and every candidate come before you in any forum, symposium, conference, and you have to ask the hard questions. You're the only ones who can determine if the individual has the qualifications necessary to be a member of the Philippine Senate. And I would like to take the challenge. I would like you to ask me the tough questions.
All right, on that note, good luck to you, Edu Manzano.
Thank you, Karen.
Who knows, actually? Yeah. Right now, what are you polling? Did you have a survey taken?
I'll let you know later.
All right.